Gordon and Peggy Bryant's problems began when they visited their local branch of the Cheltenham and Gloucester Building Society to find out about a loan that would give them some extra income on top of their pensions. They say the society advised them to contact financial advisers Aylesbury Associates. They borrowed £50,000 from the Building Society, which was paid to Aylesbury Associates, who, say the couple, promised them an annual return of 15 to 25% on their money. But 18 months later, the investment firm went bust, and the couple found their capital had dropped in value by £12,000, and they owed nearly £10,000 in interest to the Cheltenham and Gloucester as well.
Well, I was absolutely staggered. I mean, it goes from one extreme to the other. I had no inkling of what was happening until around the autumn of last year.
The loan was secured against his house, so this morning, worried about the possibility of losing his home, Gordon Bryant joined 21 other Bromley pensioners who are victims of similar schemes to lobby the Building Society's directors at their annual general meeting today and to try to get them to admit liability. His wife Peggy would have liked to go with him, but the couple couldn't afford the additional £10 coach fare that would have cost. After the meeting, still with their placards held high, the pensioners heard that the Gloucester and Cheltenham would not recompense them directly and that they should seek compensation from the Investors Protection Scheme, a body set up to investigate claims from people like the pensioners. In the meantime, the Cheltenham and Gloucester has said it won't repossess any mortgaged homes and will wait until the protection scheme decides what should be done, if anything, to repay monies lost by the pensioners. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.